In seinem Buch LSD-Psychotherapie befasst sich Stanislav Grof auch mit der Bedeutung von Musik und sagt, dass
in his book LSD Psychotherapy, Stanislav Grof addresses also the importance of music, and he refers to it as an essential part of LSD psychotherapy.
Das Wort ist wichtig.
Often patients reported the flow of music, this word is important, made it easier for them to relinquish their psychological defense mechanisms and enable them to surrender completely to the experience. It is important to keep in mind now that there is a process to an LSD experience that is quite obvious. It is a process including many various states of consciousness that one may undergo during an LSD experience. So within this process, music can have a completely different relevance to the person than it normally would. Grof mentions, for example, that in the latent period, before the effects of the drug begin, music of a low, flowing and soothing character would be appropriate. After the beginning of the psychedelic effect, music of an inspiring and uplifting nature would be recommendable. And if the patient, as Grof calls them, isn't under the full effect of the substance after 1.5 hours, the time comes for powerful, emotion-invoking music. Grof offered in Spring Grove primarily classical music by Scriabin, Brahms, Schumann or Grieg. By the 4th hour of the LSD experience, one is approaching its peak. According to Grof, this is the opportunity for a strong emotional and spiritual breakthrough, and therefore transcendental music with a powerful nature would be especially suitable, like spiritual music by Mozart, Bach or Berlioz. And at the end, relaxed and smooth music is appropriate again. Alongside classical composers, Grof also recommends modern recordings, as for example by Deuter, Paul Horn, Ravi Shankar or Zen meditation music. And of course everything that is categorized as world music on the market. Trance-enhancing music with a more or less rhythmic character is generally seen as essential and useful. Whoever offers a certain type of music to others during a psychedelic experience is usually acting upon the assumptions of his or her personal preferences. But it is more important to clarify musical preferences in advance, according to the perceptions of the person that is to live the experience. So, I thought about 8 points that I consider important. Firstly, it is a question with what kind of motivation one is choosing to experience the LSD trip. Is it rather hedonistic, meaning is it oriented towards general pleasure in life, or is it applied towards consciousness expansion? As we all know, these don't necessarily exclude each other, though a primary hedonistic motivation shouldn't be generally devalued. I myself once joined a group at SEPT, Swiss Physician Society for Psychoanalytic Therapy, where Peter Gasser, as the president of SEPT, exclusively used carefree, harmonizing and pleasant music, among others such as live guitar music by Otto Silmer from Konstanz. I don't know if he's here. He has made great CDs and wrote a book on sound therapy. Second, should the LSD trip be conducted alone, in pairs in a private location, or as a group experience? For individually based experiences, Grof's criteria are of course useful. For a couple using the LSD experience erotically, with low doses of psychedelics, it is highly recommended to use sounds of flowing nature, such as Sufi music or gentle, pulsating percussion music from all continents.
Pulsierende Perkussionsmusik aus allen möglichen Kontinenten.
Concerning group experiences, the question arises, what are to determine a common topic for the collective trip, which can of course also be intensified musically. For example, the Norwegian song by Mary Boine about howling wolves would be appropriate for a men's group, as also music devoted to the counterpole of the male principle, being the animal, as Carl Gustav Jung refers to it.
Männlichen Prinzips gewidmet ist, nämlich der Anima im Sinne Carl Gustav Jungs.
Und es It is obvious that such an abrupt change of thematic focus should be avoided, considering the slow processes of a psychedelic experience. Instead, it should be carefully graded and overall staged dramaturgy in accordance with the previously discussed topics intended to fully aid in the self-experience. Third, especially in group experiences, it could be recommended to be oriented towards the criteria of so-called film music, which I won't explain any further. I believe this speaks for itself. Fourth, in contrast to Stanislav Grof's idea to decline the impact of written text, I think, especially in the case of psychedelic journeys, oriented towards the expansion of the consciousness and evolutionary progress, in my opinion, consciously quoted texts or music which is lyrically oriented can be extremely constructive. Some who want to have an LSD experience may pick up any music labeled as meditative or psychedelic, and they may not realize early enough that even the language in the music can also have a very intense effect. For example, the album Vibrations by the Ashra Temple from the 70s was very amrock. The text from the album booklet reads, "What lives inside of you and all of us, our vibration is inside everything. The paradise is life." This sounds wonderful. But then comes the song, Flowers Must Die, starting with unstructured floating sounds, then turning up into a fierce, lashing rhythm with political lyrics, and so I believe it is necessary to think first what you want to absorb in such an important situation. Fifth, in psychedelic experiences, it is important to pay attention to the sounds. Even the best possible sound technology is just barely sufficient enough. The sound doesn't have to conform to only genres of psychedelic music, but principally every music style can enhance psychedelic experiences. Sixth, the differentiation between art and Hawkam plays a huge part in meditative music. Composer Hans Sander speaks out, quote, "A current occurrence of indescribable soul Hawkam in music labeled to be for the genre meditation, in which the cheap, euphoria-creating perfume damp of the New Age mentality will suffocate all creative impulses like insects on fly paste," end quote. Thus, if there is such a thing as a regression happening throughout a psychedelic journey, it could be related to lack of criticism, or in the literal sense, it can be experienced and integrated as a return to the roots.
Sie kann aber auch im wörtlichen Sinne als eine Rückkehr zu den Wurzeln empfunden und gestaltet werden. Siebtens.
Seventh, in this respect, I'd like to refer to Adolf Dietrich, who formulated in Zurich the main categories of altered states of waking consciousness, especially regarding the differentiation of oceanic self-transcendence and the fearful eye dissolution. These processes can merge into each other, and it can depend strongly on the music. In what direction this develops? Is it developing towards an oceanic self-transcendence or towards a fearful eye dissolution? For example, the song Flowers Must Die On one hand, it can enhance the I dissolution rather than the oceanic self-transcendence. On the other hand, though, the lyrics are somewhat centering, keeping one more alive. In LSD therapy, according to Gross principles, it is known that horror trips in the sense of a fearful eye dissolution are explicitly favorable, but only under the condition that, together with a professional companion, the subject can integrate these experiences into his worldview and his biography. When oceanic feelings of comfort are sought after, without a professional companion, and when the originally controlled eye functions dissolve in ecstasy, then it is important to truly reconsider the full impact of the term regression. Even though states of blessed childishness, harmony and relaxation can be pleasant, the way of marketing meditative music can be, as Martin Mummelter phrased it, exploiting the need for regression, and that such a transcendental outcome, as he calls it, may rather ruin than enhance the possibilities of furthering human spirituality. And lastly, 8. The question: is there a certain criteria for spiritual music? Logotherapist Otto Sock is referring to this in his book Music and Transcendence. To surrender to a great piece of sound art is more than delight. It is an experience of liberation, of the catharsis, and condensed sensory experience. In this kind of experience, man is granted the gifts of abundant light, beauty, truth, and the illumination of reality, which otherwise would be out of reach. It has been experienced with music that the existence of humankind on earth is worthy of approval. I really like this wording, that the existence of humankind on earth is worthy of approval. And Sock also says, while the melody is expanding inside of me, I realize how big my inner spaces are and how far and wide my inner emptiness is. And simultaneously, depth and height of the realms of the soul. And Sock also says, while the melody is expanding inside of me, I realize how big my inner spaces are and how far and wide my inner emptiness is, and the simultaneous depth and height of the realms of the soul, to express this aesthetically. And ultimately, the art is to recognize the preciousness of the individual soul and the realms thereof. So in this respect, I think that especially in combination with music, psychedelic experiences are well suitable for this. Self-care, more consciously organizing, because music is perceived especially intensely under the effects of LSD. It's important to realize more consciously what kind of input do I actually want to allow into my soul. In this regard, theologian Hans Küng said, one feels to be entirely turned inwards, with eyes and ears, body and mind, and when everything external, all opposites and all subjective divisions are overcome, music is no longer an opponent, but a surrounding, penetrating, bestowing inner happiness, and is extremely fulfilling. I refer back to Hoffman's continuously featured description that in a mystical experience, it is about realizing the inner and the outer world, that which is the I and the non-I, and everything outside of the I, as oneness, meaning the realms of the soul, as expressed by Adolf Dietrich, with the wording oceanic self-transcendence, are no longer highly protected. In such an experience, the borders to the external world are more and more flowing and dissolving. Thus, the one who's aiding a psychedelic voyager, or the person preparing for himself with a good choice of music, is well advised to think thoroughly in advance what I want to allow into my own soul realm. The Romanian professor for music aesthetics, George Balloon, found words that may sound slightly lofty, but in context with this congress, I believe they will certainly be understood. Quote, entering the sanctum of music is simultaneously the entrance into the inner sanctuary.
Bedeutet zugleich das Betreten des eigenen Heiligtums im Innern.